Hello, everyone. I was going to talk about Bob the Bipolar in the suicide group. That was my group. We all found each other in the pod. It wasn't hard to do. You couldn't get away from pretty much anyone, but you could sit. They had tables so you could kind of like mark your territory, so to speak, at a table. And we ended up playing cards. Because there were schizophrenics and psychotics and people like that there who were really out of touch. They were in a whole nother reality. So we just kind of found each other and sat around and talked and played cards and talked about briefly our, suicide attempts and what happened and how we got that way and made jokes about it, which isn't a good thing to do, by the way. In a psychiatric hospital, because the support staff likes to walk around and listen. That's why they do that, to what you're saying. And especially if you've were a suicide attempt, they will listen for any talk of suicidal ideation. And we would joke about it, different ways to kill yourself and stuff like that. I know, that's not funny, is it? We thought it was funny. And we would just make all these jokes. And they would, of course, go back and say, to the psychiatrist. They're still talking about it. That's not a good sign. And then you end up staying longer, just so you know. Anyway, yeah, I figured that out when they kept upping the time I had to stay there. I'm like, okay, I won't talk about it anymore. I'll think it, but I won't joke about it anymore. Yeah, I've got somewhat of a sardonic humor when it comes to that sort of thing. But anyway, and so did they, which was great because we laughed most of the days that we were together. So, Bob the Bipolar, he was a suicide attempt. That's why he was in the group, right? We all had that in common. But he really wasn't bipolar. I really don't think so. I think he was a full-blown NPD. He actually loved his bipolar so much he talked about it all the time, and he used it as an excuse for everything that he did. Now, I'm going to give a couple of examples. First, I want you to picture this though. He looked like one of those plastic squeeze dolls where you squeeze him and the head sort of blows up and the eyes pop out. That's what he looked like. And his A couple of his teeth were literally rotting out of his head. Yeah. Like you don't notice that? I mean, they were brown and rotting. He thought he was really good looking though. He thought he was really cute. And I'm sure back in the day, he probably was cute and could, get with women, with a few cute little things that he would do. Wasn't so cute at his age now. And his wife had filed for divorce, which triggered the suicide attempt. Honestly, looking at him, I couldn't blame her. He was had this really deep, raspy cough, like a smoker, really bad smoker's cough. And he had this laugh that was just ew. It's like you're not cute anymore. He acted like he was probably in his 20s. But he was, 40 something. So it wasn't cute anymore. He acted basically like a 20 something. The kind that bar hop and pick up girls and oh, everything I do is so cute. Girls love me. And I'm looking at him with this, his teeth are rotting out of his head, literally. Brown, rotting. No enamel, nothing. And this raspy, nasty cough that he had. And he's just thinking he's the shit, And so Yahweh and Tristan, who are also in the group, we're just looking at each other, being polite, like, oh, okay. It's a mental hospital. What do you expect, right? The quality of the suicide victims, right? You can't expect too much. So, we would play cards. You had to do something to pass the time. And he often would talk about himself, of course, and all of his bipolar stories. And It got so tiresome after a while that every time he walked away, we were just like, oh my God, thank God. Oh, he won't stop talking. And these stories were so freaking lame. They were so NPD juvenile type stories. So, he captured our attention one night, kept us up very late, so he could spend 30 minutes telling us the story of his last suicide attempt. And I couldn't even believe he did this, but he did. He blamed it on bipolar, and you'll see how this was NPD. Remember, narcissistic supply. Remember, center of attention has to be the center of attention. So, his daughter is having a birthday party. And he says, well, after the party, I grabbed a six pack of beer, went up to my room, the bedroom, started drinking and stuff, and he overdosed on a bottle of pills. Then, while everyone was sleeping and he was staggering around, he fell over in the middle of the living room, and they had to call an ambulance. And ta-da, there. That was his suicide attempt on his daughter's birthday. Do you see how that's NPD? Do you see how after the part he wasn't the center of attention. It was his daughter's birthday, and so he decided that that night he needed all the attention, and he went to his room, grabbed a six pack of beer, like I said, took some pills, and then they got to call an ambulance, and there was all this drama, and he blamed it on his bipolar. Now, each and every incident he described was because he was trying to be the center of attention. He thought he was cute. He honestly did. He sat there just looking at you like, aren't I cute? I'm so cute. And none of those things I did, I take responsibility for because it's my mental illness, my bipolar. It wasn't. He had to be the center of attention. So then he tells another story, and he thinks he's being so cute. And I'm just looking at him like, first of all, your stories are fucking lame, and you're not cute. But he's talking about one time he gets drunk and he's takes some motorized bicycle. It wasn't a motorcycle and it wasn't a bicycle. This I don't know what you call it. And he's in his neighborhood and he's driving it down the side of the road and he falls over and isn't he cute? He's laughing with that raspy, nasty smoker's cough that he had. And he's like expecting you to laugh along with him and go, oh, that was really cute. No, that's not cute when you're 30 something, at that time he was, and you have kids and you're married. That's not cute. Not really. Not at all. So, his wife filed for divorce papers. That was his reason for his last suicide attempt. But they had been separated and he was trying to date. So he describes this crazy woman he dated. And I'm just listening, you know. Okay, of course he has a van, right? He's like a painter or in the construction trade, something like that. And he picks her up and he says he keeps emphasizing that she keeps ha when he picks her up, she has this mug that she drinks milk out of or something like that. Like, wow, that's weird. He goes, yeah, I know. So, he goes out on a date with her, and by the end of the date, she throws this milk in his face. He kicks her out of the van and lets her find her own way home. And that's pretty much all he said. But I'm thinking, I think there's a lot more to that story. You probably were insensitive and being incredibly abusive. How did she get home? He says, I don't know. She had a phone. Aren't you cute? You're so cute. And he made it sound like It was all her fault. Wasn't she a weirdo for having this mug of milk? Which I thought was really weird anyway, but I don't know. Who knows if it was true or not. But and I don't know. He made it sound like she was like this total weirdo he was dating, and she threw this milk in his face, and oh, you poor guy. Yeah, we were supposed to sit there and listen. He would capture us, literally, all three of us, be sitting there going, It's not funny. And he's laughing with that awful, raspy smoker's cough and his rotted teeth in his head, looking like that squeeze doll, with the eyes popping out. Like, you're not cute. You're not funny. And the suicide attempt was really all about the divorce, I do believe. And he was talking about how he wasn't working anymore because of his bipolar and yada, 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 yada. What about your wife and your kid? Kids, I think he had more than one. Yeah, you see where that's going? Nobody liked him. It was bipolar, 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 bipolar. I'm not responsible for anything that I do. It's my bipolar. That's why I was suicidal. That's why I get drunk and do all the stupid shit that I do. It's my bipolar. I wasn't on my medication. I need to take my medication, blah, 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 blah. Well, it was very clear that he was an idiot. He was a total fucking idiot. Nobody could stand him. He was using it as an excuse. And you can probably, anyone who's been through a narcissistically abusive relationship can see what he was doing. In terms of being there in the hospital, being stabilized because his wife filed for divorce, and I didn't blame her. He wasn't working. She was carrying the load, raising the children, and his teeth were rotting out of his head. And supposedly, he was dating someone too, and this was all before she filed for divorce. But apparently, they were separated. I don't know. I don't know. But that was Bob the Bipolar. And what made it really hit home when he was grabbing our attention, quite literally, was when Tristan and I were talking about another patient. He was this other patient, very sweet, Japanese young man who was obviously severely cognitively disabled. Severely. He was not really verbal, chose, I think, not to talk. He had physical problems where his arms would stay by his side. He kept completely isolated to himself, but he was very sweet. He was very polite. If you talk to him, he would say something back if he had to. And he would just follow instructions, basically. Very severely cognitively impaired. And one day, Tristan had a visitor, and his father came to visit him. And just to explain real quick, how disabled this young man was, his father brings him bananas, because obviously his son likes bananas, I guess. And the young man is sitting and eating all of these bananas. This is Tristan's. She observes this and she comes back and she tells me. The young man is eating the bananas. He eats all of them, six of them, then vomits in front of his father. Yeah. As the young man is eating the banana, his father is saying, "You cannot live your life like this. You need to change. You need to stop being like this. You need to change." And the young man is eating the bananas and then vomits all over the table in front of his father. Well, I grew quite fond of this young man. He was gentle, he was sweet, he was really, he was. And he was very disabled. There was no changing. There was nothing anybody could do for him. And What happened was Tristan also, after witnessing how abusive this young man's father was, she was also the same way. She was like, oh my God, this young man, he's so sweet. He doesn't hurt anybody. He doesn't bother anybody. Just somebody be nice to him, for Christ's sake, you know? I mean, look what his father did, right? And we were talking about this at the suicide table, I'll call it, right? Well, Bob the bipolar interrupts, and he says, what about me? And we both, Tristan and I, look at each other and we're like confused. Like, what do you mean, what about you? And he says, well, he was born like that. He can't help it. He doesn't even know. He doesn't even know he's has problems. I'm like, well, of course he does. He understands language. He really does. He just doesn't talk. And Bob the bipolar is like, well, I have more problems because I'm bipolar. He doesn't know any better. He was born like that. And Tristan and I looked at each other and went, holy crap, did he really just say that about the young Japanese man? Yeah. He was actually mad at us because the two of us were empathizing with the young Japanese man and, you know, being kind and gentle towards him. And Bob the bipolar couldn't take it anymore. The attention had to be on him. Because, you know, he was retarded. He doesn't know any better. He was born like that. Who cares? Care about me. I'm the one with all the crazy bipolar stories and can't help myself. Yeah. It was at that moment I went, okay. I don't think bipolar is your problem. I think you're NPD. I think your problem is you think you're really cute. You think you need to be the center of attention all of the time. And you do crazy, stupid shit to maintain that focus of attention on you, including ruining your daughter's birthday party with a suicide attempt. How fucking selfish was that? Yeah. Anyway, not sure if that's going to help anyone, but as you can see, I really didn't like Bob the bipolar. Peace out.